Okay, so one of the things that may be required where you live is to bond the hot water lines together. So if the electricity, if somehow electricity starts to flow through these pipes, it will jump this and miss the water heater, since a lot of these now have electrical power running to them instead of just being only having gas running to them. So we've had to make some accommodations for that. And so I'm going to show you how to bond the water heaters together, the hot water lines together. And then where I live, we also have to bond the gas line to it, because then it's kind of in the way. So I tend to like do it up high, and it also sometimes will make people a little uncomfortable to see copper wires running, exposed copper wire running between all these pipes. But this is for bonding. So we're going to bond the gas line, the cold water, and the hot water. Okay. And mine doesn't have this, but sometimes there's a dielectric between these two, and you have to do it above that. Okay. So if this pipe were to become a part of the electrical circuit, it would go to ground, protecting all the electronics in the hot water heater itself. At least that's the theory. So you can get kits like this for just bonding the hot water heater at any home goods, any hardware store. I just got a two set here. Okay, and it comes with the proper size gauge wire. Now, some code inspectors may say this needs to be stranded ground wire. I'm going to use the ground wire. I'm going to use the solid here to see if that works. I'm hoping that it does. If the code inspector calls me out on it, it's an easy swap out. But since where I live, the code isn't very clear, it might just be based on the mood of the inspector. The first thing I like to do is to make sure that this one line is going to be long enough for all three pipes. So I want to find a location where it will easily get to all three. So I'll just do it right here. I think this is going to work out really well. I have to cut back some of the insulation on the hot line. One of the issues that I'm having here is I was going to come across this way because the hot water pipe comes here, but there's a soldering joint right here. And I prefer, if possible, to stay away from the soldering joints as much as possible, because when you compress this on there, you don't want to compress the pipe and mess up the joint here. That would be really bad. So again, I think I'll just go from here to here over to here, and then I'll cut that away. So for the black pipe here, the gas line, I got a little bit more of a robust grounding connector. So you just want to make this snug. All right.
It's really important when you're tightening these connectors down that you don't over tighten them or get them too close to a joint, because you just don't want to damage the water line. Damaging the gas line would be much harder. You definitely want to be very cautious when you're tightening down either the hot water line or the cold water line. Both super important. All right. The other thing to note here is that I tried to loosen up the bonding screw before I got started. This would allow me to easily connect it and run the solid gauge wire through it.
All right, so now all three of these are up. So I'm gonna just...
So here I'm just going to run the wire and put them all to the bonding screw for each one. You have to manipulate this a little bit. Just be a little extra careful that when you're bending the wire itself, you're not moving the water lines too much. You always want to be very respectful of that if you can. The reason being is you don't, again, want to loosen up any of the joints for water leaks now or in the future.
And there we go. So now we have the hot water, cold water, and the gas lines all bonded together. Okay, so the last thing you need to do is go ahead and put a little tag on here that basically just says, hey, this is an electrical connection, do not remove. Again, they're about a dollar, no big deal. Just pop it through here, and there it is. Do not remove. That's the last thing you need to do. and these are now bonded together. And it's really pretty simple. This is something that you'd have to talk to your local code inspector to see if they require. We live in a pretty congested area, so the code tends to be as far as conservative as it can be, especially when it comes to fire hazards. So this is just an extra little step. Cost me, you know, get all this stuff over at any hardware store. And anyway, I hope this video helped to show how to bond the gas line and the hot water heater together. Thanks.